Because I ride the bicycle, so they take my bicycle off. Okay, anyway, so when I'm having the lecture about e-commerce, my professor asked me to write a shopping cart in YouTube. And don't forget that day I'm just having 3 years in university. So at that day, I even not yet start learning about SQL or HTML or section or cookies or any other mail, but they asked me for a complete and mature shopping cart system. What the hell? So I'm really angry about that, and finally I searched multiple systems, and then I found Drupal that I may start with as a shopping cart framework, as a content management system. So I go and ask my professor, okay, unless you give me a tutor, tutoring me for 3 days or a week for all the technical skills that I need to have, else I would like to start with this CMS. Would you like to let me do so? Okay, then finally he gave up and then let me do so, and then I start my life with Drupal, and then also later on once I graduate, I start my business with Drupal too. So now I usually build website for my clients. For example, some client about Subtrend Michael, CNN, UST, PolyU, or other else company in Hong Kong too. Okay, so I'm also organizing some activity as open source organizer. Okay, so some recent activities, photo. And anyone attend the bar camp before? Or anyone have bar camp?
Oh.
214. In CUHK. Yes. CHK 2 years ago, there is also a bar camp, which is a conference organized in CUHK. I would like to say that I've been one of the speakers for such a conference since 2008. And every year, I try to stand up and try to speak twice now in English. So please forgive about my poor sentence and also my language. Okay, anyway, I will try my best to share some experience. Okay, my company background, we are working for some open source stuff. Okay, so back to the main topic, why I'm here today, because I would like to share something about Agile. Then you will think about, what are you talking about? You're talking about you're doing some web project, building websites, so why you're talking about Agile project management? Oh, because we also have too many projects that need to manage in parallel style. So finally, I need to manage my employees, my team partner, and my co-workers. And most likely, I would like to hire someone which is energetic and just fresh graduated. So finally, also, they just have no idea about how production environment and job development should work. So finally, I found some software which called Jira, which called Conference, and so on and so on. And I found it okay, quite good. And then so finally, I use it, and then I even become their consultancy partner. So you can see the bottom left, I'm also the Edilson. Edilson is a software company in Australia, and they have some spotlighted software, for example, Jira, which is ticketing management, and Conference, which is team cooperation software. And I can say that even NASA, when they send the satellite to Mars, the Explorer, I don't remember the name, that project is also organized with Jira. And LD is also using Jira and Conference. Hong Kong's Coca-Cola also even using Jira for the production line, manufacturing line management with such workflow control management system. Okay, so finally, that's why I'm here, because I keep on using open source software. They also open source Lover, and then that is a good project management software, and then I gain a lot of the experience about how to do a good agile project management after multiple time of fail. Okay, it's not easy. It's not easy, but today I will try my best to let you have some general idea. Okay, some sharing. Okay, that's all true photo. We have a lot of ladies, so if you would like to join, okay. Okay, anyway, so today's topic, what is agile development? And then, why using agile development? So next is talking about, okay, how agile teams work daily. I give you some general best practices. Okay, so finally, I would like to give you a demo or tutorial, but in between, during the first step, I will already give you some screencasts. So most likely, you will already have some general idea. So hopefully, my network is working, and then I can give you a demo. If not, then just talk about the screencasts, okay? So first of all, anyone learn about agile development, or at least you know the terms about agile? Are you kidding me? Most say that. Know that for sure that he should know that. Okay. No one know about what is agile? Oh, okay. Last year there's more hand, but this year.
Yeah, this is
okay. That's why I need to give you some more idea. Okay. So, first of all, anyone manage a project with Excel? Excel. So that you list out all the items that you need to do in the project and do it one by one, at least in Excel.
Be using Google Doc.
Okay, Google Doc. Okay. I better say a spreadsheet or Google Doc. In my old bad day, I may even just use the notepad. Anyone you just use the notepad with the TST or... Okay, at least, I understand what is our starting point. Okay. Do you like that? Do you like that style? Usually you will miss a point. And then it's not flexible to reflect the requirement changes, right? And the key point is, okay, unless you're using Google Doc, which is some online team cooperating tools, else you will just hold the copy and no one will be able to team cooperating together with you. So it's a nightmare, right? Okay, so what is Agile? First of all, the first stage is using Notepad. Next stage is using Excel or something else to manage in the waterfall style. So okay, let's say I have 4 weeks for doing the project. So first week, I need to do the framework. Second week, I need to do some debug. And then third week, layout. And then final week for the UAT or the user assessment test or something. Okay, that is so-called waterfall. But I would like to say that usually waterfall will fail because you can't predict everything, even the bug and also the bottleneck. Okay, so people find some other way. Why don't try fast and then fail fast and then pivot your development direction fast? Okay, so that's why we have Agile. So Agile is a general methodology. You can have many different kind of implementation. Yeah, for example, Scrum, which we will mention, Agile, Kanban, we will mention, or something even called extreme development, or etc. But anyway, there is just depends on your habit. But I would like to say that Scrum and Kanban is most likely fit for daily use. Okay, so what is the point? Okay, Agile is talking about some software development method. So the methodology. Okay, you will able to team organize together with other else team or something else. So you dedicate the requirement to someone and then they do the job and then they send you back. Okay, individually. So that you can see that they promote adaptive planning. So which means that when something you out, you hit the bottleneck, then why don't we fix and we change the direction as soon as possible? Okay, so keep on having some feedback and then keep on having some testing, keep on having some deliverable, having some workable demo, and then okay, fail fast and then change fast. Okay, so this is the general idea. You build something when we need to, we so called the MVP, the minimal viable proposition, something. So minimally work. You don't need to build everything. You just build something, and then later on, you ensure that it is always functional. For example, you write some test case or something else. Okay, then you build something more on top of it. And then again, you ensure this is okay, and then you build something more. Again and again and again, keep on making it larger and larger. So that's called Agile. So every time you will plan, then you will implement, you will test, and then you will accept it, and then you will go to next round, once again, and once again, and once again. So you're not doing the complete project once together. You're one round by one round, okay? Okay, so, but even by one round, how can we manage it more systematically? Because if you're just starting with Notepad or something else, you don't have modern production environment, so-called development process management, okay? So we need to share some common methodology. So what is called Scrum? Okay, Scrum is talking about manage your project in some iteration base. So let me take some example. For example, if I take a website project from the client, let's say charge it for 3 months for development, I will segment it into 6 sprints. Each sprint talking about 2 weeks. What's that mean? So every 2 weeks before it's done, I will have a meeting with the client, confirm what is the schedule for the ongoing next 2 weeks, and then I will tell the client, please shut up, shut your mouth up, don't bother me, let me focus and work for that 2 weeks. And then later on, I will give you a functional demo for all the committed requirements, and then you sign it off, and then we plan for other thing else. Okay, you get my point? So I will segment it into 6 rounds, so I will meet with the client, let's say, more than 6 times in order to keep on continuously deliver and continue having some acceptance approval. You get my point? Okay, so this is the general idea. So first of all, you need to have the sprint planning. Okay, this is the idea. So you can see that in the, here is the product backlog. Usually you will convert your client's needs into some human readable or simple language, and then import form one by one. And then later on, you group it into one batch, the red, in the orange area, so which is called the next sprint. Okay, then you fresh that out, put it into a schedule, and then work. Okay, then your team get the individual duty, and then they work it day by day to try to get the job done. Okay, so every day we may also have some daily scrum meeting. For example, like this, we sit down or stand up and then talking about three questions: what you have done yesterday, what you are going to do for today, and any difficulties. But don't looking for someone to help you now. Okay, please raise all your difficulty. Then someone who understands how to fix it should give you some help after the meeting. Get my point? Don't waste the time. So we're not trying to have the daily meeting in 2 hours. No. Just try to make it within 15 minutes. Okay? Stand up. What you do yesterday? What did you do yesterday? What are you going to do today? And any difficulties? Let's share it. Okay? Then this is the daily squad meeting. Okay, then later on, after the daily squad meeting, you will get the job done, and then finally you will have to finish the work. You have to finish the work. And then you ask for a sprint review meeting with the client. And then later on, you go back to here once again. All right? Okay, so just some general idea. So for sure that you have the product owner, which is usually your client, and then the development team. Okay, so those labors, those slave, okay? And then the squad master, which is, okay, translated from project manager. Okay, Scrum Master is also such kind of project manager. Okay, they manage the project, but they should understand what is Scrum methodology. Okay, so the user story. Okay, first of all, as I talked about, you will gather the client's information, the requirement, and then make it into point form, right? So you will make it into something so-called the user story, and then you give some value to it, which is called the user point. User point. So in my team, usually I say 1 point equivalent to 1 hour, 1 man hour. So which means that if I give a story with 8 points, which means that it should most likely work for 1 day. Okay, I will ask my coworker to accept or reject my assumption for that 8 hour or not before they accept my duty. You get my point? So I'm not trying to ask my coworker to work for something that needs 24 hours, but I just give 8 hours. No. I try not to do so. Okay, you should give me some feedback and then let's discuss. For sure that if I have only totally 400 hours and I only able to maximally give you 8 hours, then okay, please forgive because the other one else also needs some time. Okay, forgive about your poor boss this time. I can't get too much budget from the client. Okay, so forgive me, but I will try to make everything balanced and try not OT. Okay. Okay, so I have some idea, and then let's mark it into the board. Okay, so this is the demonstration of the backlog. So you have everything in point form. Would that be much better than using the notepad? At least you can move it up and down with tick and drop. Okay, then you also have some value. Okay, can you see the number in the right hand side, which is so called the story point? And then you can also see the angle, the arrow in the left hand side, right? Some arrow just with one single arrow, one sometimes with two, sometimes even with a broker symbol. We will say that is so called the priority. So usually the priority will separate into five, for example, broker, critical, major, minor, transverse, so five level. And then that when combining with these two value, I will say that if that is higher priority, and which occupy you more hours, please get it done as soon as possible. And then you will say, oh, gentlemen, are you crazy? Usually people would like to get started with something that is transfer, simple, and then just cost you a little bit time, and then I will get some confidence. I will get some progress today, and then I can tell my PM that, okay, I have get something done. Right? Okay, I know that. Everyone would like to do that. But I would like to suggest you not work in such human being. Okay? Because finally you will just having something that is very critical, but spending you 2 days or 3 days in the last 2 hours. Then finally you will have no time to get that done. Alright? So try to against your human being. Okay? Try to catch something that is higher priority, most difficult, spending you most of the time at the very beginning. Then you can go back and play your online game, okay? But don't need to stay in the lab for a whole night, all right? When I'm staying here, I have been staying in the lab for 1 week. 1 week. I just sitting down on, I just lie down on free chair and then slog in, slog out under the table and I sleep for 1 week. Just because I don't adopt this idea, okay? Try to get something that is in highest priority, most difficult, spending you more time at the very beginning. All right. Okay. Then later on, once you give the story to the developer, then they take their own duty to get the job done, so they may split it into different tasks. Okay, that is your duty, none of my business. So you get the story, you segment it into different tasks, and then you just put it from to do and then in progress. Okay, and then when it is get done, and then you put it into review, and then asking your PM to review the progress. Okay, just take and drop. Okay, you may also ask me, if I don't have such kind of software, how can I do such agile development in Scrum? Okay, go and get a map, a whiteboard, buy some 3M sticky paper, sticky note, the post-it note, and then just stick it, alright? Then you will have it. For example, you have two or three columns, and then you just write down your task, and then stick, move it. Okay, but don't put it near to a windy window. All bruised, and then your mouth will just throw into the rubbish bin and then, ah, shit. Okay, so try not to do so. Okay, so finally, one of the benefits why we need to have an online Scrum board, because you can have the burndown chart for some statistic. So ideally, your team should work out in the green line. So the story point, the hours, should burn on time according to the green line, but usually it should be like this. That's always true, because thank you. Okay, that's always correct, because if you get something that is difficult to be done at the very beginning, consider at the first few days you may just horizontal. But then once that gets done quickly, and then it may go down. So ideally you should like this. But usually my team is like this, or sometimes just go to here, okay? Then you need to give them a punch, okay? But at least I have some report so that I can manage the team, okay? So even if delay, you will still try to make it manageable. Ah, just one more point. So for example, if a project asking for 600 hours and I have I have 3 months, so that I separate it into 6 sprints. You can imagine that each sprint for 100 hours, right? Ideally. But I will try to be mad and ridiculous and asking my team member to do 120 hours per sprint. Okay, not because I want to be evil, it's I want to let them not OT. Are you kidding me? No. Because sometimes when you do some task that you may face some bottleneck, and then you need to round into another task, another duty, and get that done. But if I just give you 100, and then you have no way, and then finally you just get me 80%. And then finally the overall project will delay for 20%. Ah, then everyone need to OT. You get my point? I give you additional 20. I give you the flexibility to adjust it. Okay? Then finally you take your job done. Alright? Okay, so again, some burndown chart example. Okay?
Oh, right. I want to ask the questions.
Oh, okay, yes.
What is that? Like some drop, but
Going up?
Yeah, it's going up.
Why going up?
Yeah.
Because the programmer said yes, but the PM said no, it's failed. I reject it. You're disqualified. So, you're popping up once again, okay? You get my point? So that's not just talking about, because if I take a job from done to do once again, okay, then if we open it, you need to get the job done once again for me. You get it?
Yes.
Always like this. This is even quite ideal. This is already even quite ideal. No, don't laugh at it. Okay. Usually not in this way. Usually not in this way. So that's why I can share that at least you need to understand the methodology. You understand what is the paradigm, but you also need to understand the phase, okay? Usually you can't do that. Okay, so seems like quite complicated, right? First of all, you need to have the planning, you need to put in the backlog, and then you need to segmentate the which task go to this sprint, and then you need to manage the sprint. If I'm just having a project, let's say for Paul, for 2 weeks, are you kidding me? 3 days for a sprint? No. It's too crazy for such kind of management. Why don't make this much more fast and rapid? So next is called Kanban. Kanban is very simple. Job come, then job get done, and then finish. Another job come, and then job get done, and then finish. Very simple. Okay? So you just try to get all job done. No. If someday you get all job done, then you will lost your job. Right? So that is ridiculous. Just because that you need to prioritize your job. Don't daydream about that. Someday you have no more job in the task board. Because if that happens, then which means that your company have no more duty and then you will be fine. Okay, that's again ridiculous. Okay, so make it very simple. Just 3 columns to do working and then done. Okay, so just like this. So the key point is no more planning, no more initial planning. When some duty come and then go to here, you need to make it. If you want to make it higher priority, then you just change your priority and then it may go to here. And then if it is now taking working in progress, then just move it. Okay. Why it is in, for example, red or yellow? For Kanban, usually we have an idea about maximum capacity for that status. For example, you can think about, for in progress, if my team has 4 people, let's say each people working in left brain and right brain, so that finally you can take 8 tasks in parallel. But that's still just 8 tasks, right? If I let you put 20 tasks in parallel, yeah, I can let you do so, but you're just kidding yourself, right? Why don't you just move something back? Because you are not focusing on that now, right? Focus on something, and then get that done, and then take something out, pop something out and do it, okay? That's Kanban. So you're not necessary to make everything stuck in the progress and telling you that, okay, I'm planning for the client with that, okay, just move back, okay? So finally, again, if you have 4 people, I would like to recommend, for example, 4 to 6, something in the progress, that's enough. Let everyone try to focus on something, not in interrupt, and then get the job done. Okay, that's Kanban. Kanban is much more simple, okay? For sure that finally, when we're just finding the result, we're using some velocity graph or something else. Okay, well, I know that you want to ask something, but I don't understand what this graph is talking about. Generally, I don't understand what's talking about. I can tell you some general idea. For example, if the dot is larger, which means that it has more subtasks, so it seems like much more important. And then if it is too high, it seems like stay longer than average in the board, and something important, which means that it is solved much quickly than normal, okay? But I will not manage in such man with my member, because, okay, I'm just having a small team, don't make it too fancy. Okay, but this is something also meaningful. For example, this is something get done, and which is to do and working in progress or something else. So this graph may be much more meaningful. Get my point? So that generally you can think about, okay, for this period, okay, a lot of stuff is working in progress, but this much of that is getting done, okay? So this graph will be much more meaningful. Okay,
is it normal? Because the to-do must be like dropping a bit, but
okay, now at the end... again, it may reopen.
Okay.
Because of the task failed or sent back to the previous status, so finally it may fluctuate. Okay? But long story short, just think about a Kanban board as simple as this. If you think that it's high priority, then you make it higher. And then if it's ready to do it, then you just move it here. And then go. Okay? Get the point? Okay. So, okay, give you some quick review. Wait a moment. 1, 2, 3. Okay, anyone would like me to speak in English? Please raise up your hand. Oh, 講咗廣東話.
講咗.
唔係有喺度嘅，定係講英文嘅。依個係我喺外邊講開 speech 嘅習慣嚟嘅，因為盡量令到個個都 enjoy 啦嚇。咁不過學下冇話齋咁啊，可以夾啲啦嘛。OK， 俾你睇少少個快嘅個 comparison 啦。Scrum 就係有一個時間段落嘅。好處係咩呢？因為你可以同個客講唔好嘈我啦，俾啲時間我做嘢啦，等我專心做啦。你偷到啲時間，你千祈唔好同客用 campaign 啊！ 佢日日好似女朋友追奪命追雲哥咁追你，問你嗰樣得未嗰樣得未，我嗰樣想改佢喎，咁啊慘啦 ，OK？ 咁就咧 ，Wong 咧係避免咗3個月淨係見頭一次同尾嗰次，然後跟住爆煲再做多3個月，然後所以你令佢有啲 regular 嘅時間去見你個客咧，咁就用 Wong 嘅啫 ，OK？ Campaign 咧多數我攞嚟做 internal 嘅 management 嘅 business management 嘅，所以例如我有客要傾咁，我咪擺到落去 campaign 咯。我要交交税，起高鐵，得啦冇嘢，唔講，今日唔講。OK， 咁嗰啲嘢嘅時候，咁我咪要一個寫低咯。咁我咪跟住揾人去做，做完就得啦。咁嗰啲嘢其實你冇乜時限性噶嘛，你明唔明我意思啊？咁嗰啲嘢你咪揾 campaign 做咯。咁但係對客咧嘅外邊 project 或者 internal 嘅 product development 咧，其實最好咧就揾 Scrum 嘅。 咁你個有得排次序做得比較爽手啲 ，OK？ 好，最萬惡嘅嘢啦 ，waterfall， 得㗎啦，第一句講完㗎，夠㗎啦，我受夠啦，唔好再㗎啦，唔係好好啊，你有任何 file language 都係塞曬落去啦，冇乜錯㗎啦，簡單嚟講，我覺得 waterfall 呢件事係傻㗎。 你就算孔明再細，未卜先知，估到100% 都會爆煲嘅，咁有咩用咧？黐鬼線！跟住仲有個最搞笑係啲 project， 如果係例如你接咗政府嗰啲 project 咧，佢同你講要做1年嗰啲咧，明知錯都繼續要搞落去嗰啲咧，咁你就好鬼閉翳嘅。即係個 technology 已經變曬啦，但係個問題你仲繼續用。OK， 唔係好想講，不過都要講。有冇聽講過而家電子道路收費系統想揾咩？Shit！ 因為 GPS 啦嘛，新加坡。 咪仔準備淘汰 RFID， 佢話走去用 RFID， 佢哋啲 project 係咁啊，咁所以咧 waterfall， 咁你真係死俾佢睇。OK， 好，咁啊而且你 planning 有 once 梗係唔可能㗎啦，你 plan 1年前嘅1年後嘅嘢喎，自己個世界都變曬啦。OK， 亦都其實冇乜睇中間嘅，啲成日都係話，我臨尾得咪得咯，過一陣已經過鬼島海，多數都係 P 咗喺度嘅。OK， 好，多數咧你開頭咧就諗咧隻船咧就好靚㗎，肯定撐得到出去㗎，點不知撐到半島咧你已經係亂曬大龍㗎啦，去到。 去到臨 UAT testing 嘅時候咧，其實隻船已經半沉㗎啦。臨出到街咧，其實咧你嗰瞬間呃到人咧，就當過咗海上神仙㗎啦，就算數啦，跟住即刻出到去就當機啦。咪刪開嚟
project
嚇？講呢啲大家都明㗎啦。OK， 好，咁所以其實咧建議你都係用 Azure 啦，一個原因咧係你對自己誠實啲啦。 早死早超生啦！其實同啲 startup 嗰樣嘢都係一樣意思嘅，不過今日我唔講 startup 嘅嘢啦，我係一個 startup 嘅人，講啲 startup。咦？搞錯啊！唔好理佢住。唉 ，OK， 好 ，waterfall 就 feedback 唔到，又時間內又成啦嚇，咁啊，所以都係建議你用噶啦。OK， 好啦，依度就講下，睇下先，我仲有幾多時間 ？OK。 哇！我講一半咁，要快啦。好，咁啊，依度其實就講實際嘅運作啦。嗱，因為其實頭先你都見到我個 WiFi 已經俾人剁咗啦。咁所以，你揾我
login
咪得咯。冇住啦，我快啲 screencast 先，我驚爆唔足。你哋係俾我去到幾點㗎？搭三。搭三啊 ？OK， 咁我做都係快少少先啦。15分鐘講完個 screencast， 15分鐘睇下有冇得 demo 或者俾你哋問問題好冇。OK， 好。實際運作係點咧？實際運作其實多數日中咧就分4個步驟嘅 ，plan document， 即係頭先咧你哋講個 notepad 嗰啲啊。 TXT 化嗰種咧都係 documentation work management 嚟。啊，冇睇少呢個喎。做呢個 documentation management 嗰個係好鬼重要嘅喎。好鬼重要啊！有冇睇過 Hunter X Hunter？ 有冇睇過打 Green Island 最尾嗰下咧打排球嗰嘢咧？最緊要係邊個啊？
中間那個咯。
中間幾度啊嗰個啊？
1%。
冇錯，因為其實最重要嗰個人咧就係中間做佔住嗰個咧，對住嗰班咧講火星文嘅developer，同埋嗰班覺得自己講緊地球話，但其實都係講緊火星話嘅 client。咁佢仲要中間咧就夾住咧就去解決佢。咁其實點解決咧就係揾 documentation 去解決佢噶啦。OK。咁啊，跟住當佢解決完啲 documentation work 嘅嘢，去俾嗰班以為自己識睇英文嘅人去睇咗啲嘢，佢啲 client 啊，之後咧，咁就要俾翻啲 project management 嘅人，即係 developer 去睇啦。咁跟住佢就用咗 Agile project management 啦，因為 developer 都唔想 OT 嘅，其實你估個幹好平咩？段跟程咁樣真係又爆兩個幹。OK， 咁佢跟住咧，唔想一個唔該當機個 shift file 唔見咗或者乜嘢，跟住啲曲要寫過咧，咁梗係 GIT 啦。喂，因為已經係學緊用 GIT 噶。
個個都係㗎啦，
個個都用緊㗎啦嘛。啊，信我一件事，你眼瞓準備打錯字就 commit 一次，你寫錯咗曲，但係又唔知寫錯乜嘢又 commit 一次，你寫到得咗你又 commit 一次，你準備去廁所屙個大你都去 commit 一次 ，OK？ 係任何時間你都 commit 就得㗎啦 ，commit 啦 ，commit 啦 ，commit 啦 ，commit 到某個上下之後，啊，如果你覺得太亂啦。你就最好一陣間再講啦 ，branch choice 先 ，branch choice 嚟去做，跟住亂咁 commit 完之後咧，到你個頭同尾一對一個 diff 之後得咧 ，rebase 咗佢啦，淨係變翻一個 commit 啦 ，OK， 自己啲衰嘢俾自己睇得㗎啦 ，OK， 但你記得要 commit， 有冇人打 RPG 唔 save 㗎？冇理由㗎嘛 ，OK， save 啦，你 save 啦，係咁 save 就得㗎啦，咁所以你要 GIT， OK， 咁最後嗰樣嘢就係 CI 啦，喂，寫曲有冇人而家寫 test case 啊？咩叫 test case 啊？等先，有冇人知咩叫寫 test case 啊？知 ，OK， 即管講。
即例如一個 function， 你寫完個 function 之後，你知道某啲 input 對於某啲 input 你想要你寫完個 function 之後，你知道對於某啲 input 你知道一定我都有判嘅，咁你就將啲 input 分配啊，咁樣對翻曬一啲，然後揾個 program 自動 run 下，睇下對曬啲 input 落去之後，係咪可以幫你搞判咁樣
？OK， 我再講多次。其實啱曬㗎啦，有個 function， 你知個 in， 你應該知對應嗰個 out。你唔鬼使你個 black box 究竟寫緊一個係好簡單嘅嘢，定寫緊一架電單車嘅 level， 定係寫緊係航空母艦級嘅打字機？你唔使理佢點嘅 black box， 你都唔鬼使理佢。有個 in 有個 out， 你知係咁㗎啦。你寫定一個 test case， 我而家有個 in 塞落去，打翻開佢之後，佢應該出嗰嚿嘢，咁就叫 test case。咁點解要寫 test case 咧？尤其是點解最好唔好知個 internal logic 嘅 test case 要寫多啲咧？因為你一路做緊 Agile 嘅時候啊，你可能今期寫咗個功能係 work 咗，但係下期你需要改咗個 implementation 嘅。但係 existing 過嘅嗰啲 test case 咧，你因為同個客交代咗㗎啦嘛，你唔可以改個 result 㗎。所以 implement 可以 improve test case 最好唔好改，只可以繼續加，明唔明啊？咁所以咧，再加埋一個問題就係寫 test case 唔係寫曲唔寫 test case 同你。一路行，但係我高住個頭，哎呀踩屎添，有咩分別咧？冇分別嘅喎，你其實就係高住個頭，我咁都行喎，點算啊？你實撲街嘅喎 ，OK？ 你要望下有冇嘢噶嘛，有冇望下中唔中招噶嘛，撐唔撐招皮噶嘛 ？Test case 嘅工作嘅意思就係咁啦。所以而家其實喺 open source 嘅人咧，基本上寫親 source code 就會寫 test case 啦。咁而且俾個少少 sharing 你啦，例如我做 Drupal 嘅 developer， 其實我做咗十幾年㗎啦。早期喺 Drupal 四五六七嗰啲時候咧，好慘嘅。我寫咗個 patch， 因為嗰時仲未用 GIT， 都唔係 SVN， 而用緊 CVS， 真係慘到爆炸。每一個 commit 都要掟上去 server， 而且得一個人可以 commit 個 source code， 唉，超癲。咁所以你只可以寫咗個 diff file 出嚟咧，就 request 佢去收。咁但係問題係點解人哋要收你啊？點知你啲嘢得唔得？咁你就要 A 契弟咁咧，周街周圍咧 A 全世界啲契弟咧，幫我可唔可以 commit， 可唔可以試下 apply 個 patch， 然後試下睇下佢 run 唔 run 到啊？佢應該 expect 得 result 係咁上下嘅咯咁。跟住你 A 得人哋三五七個月，佢終於試一下 fail 咗喎，你再改過啦咁。癲啊！癲啊！阿媽娘親啊，喊爹冇娘啊，癲嘅。OK， 我試過寫咗一個 patch， 我擺咗咗三年都未收噶。咁但係而家去到 Drupal 七之後又點咧？佢哋每一個功能都要寫 test case， 所以咧，當你寫一個新功能想要 propose 出嘅時候咧，一啲 test case 理論上會行過你啲 source code 㗎。 如果你啲所所有嘅 logic line 都俾人，唔係個 comment line 啦嚇 ，logic line 係啦 coverage。如果你係 100% coverage 嘅話咧，即係話所有嘅 logic 嘅 expected in out 嘅 logic 你都行過曬咧，咁啊梗係好啦。如果你再寫咗啲新嘅 source code， 咁而家本來有1000行，而家1100行，咁如果你冇加 test case， 個 test coverage 咪應該跌咗啊，變咗90%啦，咁佢就唔收你噶啦。佢就會講：咁你唔該寫翻啲 test case， run 翻你啲 test 咯 ，run 翻你啲新 source code 咯 ，run 翻到100%俾我啦，咁我收你啦。跟住佢跟住先問：好，等我睇下你個 test case log logic 先。佢就睇回收先喎，睇完回收之後，哦，好似有幾 logic 喎，好啦，睇下你個 implement 得唔得啦。跟住佢先嚟睇你 implementation， OK。但係 in between 咧，因為寫咗 test case， 我哋最尾嗰樣嘢就叫 continuous integration 咧。你每次一抌上個 community 度或者抌上去俾人睇咧，有個 server， 有個奴隸獸，有個機械奴隸獸，唔係 AlphaGo 啊，就幫你自動就去攞咗啲 source code 去 clone 一次出嚟咧，然後就去 run 一次你寫嘅 test。咁然後如果你寫咗已經衰咗，佢已經話俾你聽，你唔使去見江東父老㗎啦，你自己畫埋去埋牆角度畫圈圈，畫完先至再攞出街俾人睇啦 ，OK。好，快啲嘅講，好，都話啦 ，project manager 嘅工作就係將 product owner 即係你個客啊，嗰班地球人啊所講嘅地球話轉翻做 point form 先啦 ，in simple English 啦 ，convert 翻佢做 point form 先啦，然後就俾翻班 developer 啦。OK， 記住一樣嘢，千祈唔好飲得你個客亂鳩24咁去到噏，你 manage 佢啊，唔好俾佢 manage 你，佢哋毀食你個咩叫 development 㗎，天花龍鳳㗎，佢只會諗到第一個 stream。同埋第尾個 screen 之後三個 screen 嗰個樣嘅嘢其實，跟住佢會問：唔係應該係咁嘅咩？你 developer 就依啲嘢，你哋用 IT 實識㗎啦咁樣。火都嚟嘅，始終想揾個鞋啦，一嘢除就掟佢。OK， 所以記住要 document， 而且要將佢嘅 requirement 咧，如果擺落你哋嘅功課度，就即係將嗰條題目拆翻散一個個 point form， 變咗係你又睇得明，你嘅 team partner 都睇得明。或者其實同翻個 professor 或者 tutor 講，其實都啱嘅嗰啲嘢咧，咁就係以呢種 breakdown for document 嗰個步驟啦，明唔明 ？OK， 咁好啦，實際係點咧？咁你咪將佢將啲 point， 可能佢一撇字㗎。我試過攞咗份政府嘅 tender 咧，一個 point 佢數 call 嘅一個 point 嘅 tender 到咁大行咯，仲要個 font size 係8個 PT 嗰種咯，嗰度講緊10個 point 㗎，唔好玩我。其實講10個 point 㗎，十件事嚟㗎。佢一段個咁講嘅，咁所以咧，我哋嘅工作咧就第一件事就將10段子拆翻開做10個 point 先嚇。而且咧最好每個 point 咧好似我呢度嘅 example 咁啦，每一個 point 咧都係自圓其説得到嘅，講得清楚 ，describe 得到個唔係 describe 得到佢個問題啊，佢可以 describe 得到個 deliverable 啊，交貨嗰件樣係點啊？唔該。高矮肥瘦二瘦還肥嗰啲嘢咧講得出啊！例如我做 web 嘅話就話分 page 嘅 layout design in HTML for mobile device， OK， contact form 可以有 export 嘅 result in CSV 或者 Excel。嗱，你攞住 developer， 你攞住呢個 point， 你覺得你聽唔聽得明佢做呢件事先？嗱，我冇問你中間點做先，但起碼你會形象化得到 final 你嚿嘢要交啲乜嘢嘛？啱唔啱 ？OK。Support multilingual content in 三隻 language， OK？ 可能有啲嘢都會講得比較 abstract 㗎，但 at least 你係 point 啊嘛。最緊要記住一樣嘢，你形象化諗下先。你去到埋去臨到尾同個客交貨嗰瞬間咧，你就好似去咗個鬥獸場同只獅子打交咁。你就要攞住依啲每一個 point 咧，就係你啲刀槍劍盾咧，你啲盔甲咧，就係同佢打仗啊。你每一個 point 咧要講得通，嗱我咪做咗咯。嗱，依度你講咗噶嘛，我拆翻開噶啦嘛，而拆出嚟你又覺得開會嘅時候，你開有意啲數開會，你覺得係啱嘅嘢嚟噶嘛，我而家做咗俾你啦，你收貨啦，俾錢啊 ，OK？ 咁就你依啲咧，你最好係夠 simple 到嗰班地球人睇得明，而你班 developer 嗰班火星人亦都覺得能夠做得到嘢咧，咁就為之合格啦。所以依度嘅藝術其實唔係工程嘅藝術嚟嘅，係英文嘅藝術嚟嘅。所以 developer 可以唔識英文嘅 ，OK？OK， 啊，仲有提你一句喎，一陣間我哋 next 嘅 step 咧就會講 PM，PM 頭先你見到有好多 point 㗎啦，啱唔啱？其實每一個都係一個 ticket 嚟㗎 ，ticket 可以寫 detail 㗎，不過唔好將個 requirement 寫落個堆度，因為嗰張 ticket 有 life cycle 㗎，做完你就抌走佢㗎啦嘛。如果你想同個客 發鬥翻話，喂，嗰件事你開頭唔係咁講嘅喎，你去嗰度，誒、哎，你等我等我，我湊湊嗰張 ticket 先，揾翻嗰張 ticket 出嚟同佢講，發咗啦 ，OK， 唔使咁嘅 ，documentation 嗰邊度做，連叫你班 developer 睇 spec 都去翻 document 嗰邊睇 ，OK， 唔好走去 ticket 度慢慢睇，最好 ticket 少啲字，好 description， 好 descriptive 嘅嗰句就得㗎啦 ，OK。OK， 咁如果我擺落去 Atlantic 嘅 product 度用 conference， 咁會點做呢？其實我都有啲打開雪櫃，擺隻長頸鹿落去生個雪櫃嗰種嘢。OK， 做個 page 叫 product requirement， 然後跟住你將你嗰啲要拆嘅 point 睇住嗰份文字版嘅嘢就拆 point， 拆完 point 咧就將佢變咗做 Jira 嘅 ticket， 即係 project management 嗰邊嘅 ticket 啊，即係點啊？好，呢個係 Atlantic 嘅 product 叫 conference 啊，你上網揾翻佢就得㗎啦。啊，個 PowerPoint 我會 share 翻出嚟㗎，誒唔使驚。其實可能你都未必想要 ，OK， 算啦 ，OK。咁啊，依度就當你去 conference 嗰度 create 個 sub page 咧，就話 product requirement， 咁佢就會俾咗個 template 你㗎啦。其實就比 Word 方便啲咯，因為全部都已經 online team corporation 嚟㗎啦。咁亦都有曬 template 咁，咁所以你講定邊個 appen， 跟住講跟住下邊就 describe story 啦。咁所以當我哋 describe story 咧，就好似到咁啦 ，describe 到 point form 咁。依度一陣間，如果我有得上到網就揾阿 Mo 講網就上網嘅話咧，嗰、那個 demo 其實我係全部走去 PHP Union 嗰度抄啲 Unit Test Case， 直接抄落 copy and paste copy and paste 嘅啫，所以你唔使驚我寫錯字嘅，我照抄嘅啫。OK， 咁呢啲就係佢嗰啲 test case 嗰啲 point 啦。咁你有冇發覺咧？依度咧有啲寫住 done 咗嘅，有啲咧寫住 to do 嘅。嘅意思咧就係呢啲咧嘅字咧已經係同 ticketing system 嗰邊咧 link up 咗㗎啦。咁我有 conference 有 Jira 呢啲 install 咗嘅情況之下咧，當我個 document 做完，我一 highlight 佢，等半秒佢就會 pop up 有個 prompt 掣，咁就問我要 comment 呢一句啊，定係將佢 convert 咗做一張 ticket。咁跟住我就即刻 convert， 咁佢就變咗 ticket 啦。所以最簡單就係一開波，你所有 team 即係 project management 就可以曬 documentation 喺嗰度做，做完就逐張變曬 ticket， 跟住開工。OK， 咁所以如果 link up 咗個 ticket 就好似呢個咁啦。嗱，你見到頭先左手邊有個第一個 point example。2.1 㗎嘛，啱唔啱啊？咁我拎up咗佢，就變咗張 ticket 啦。咁依邊 ticketing 又當然會有曬好多，例如講緊個 priority 啦，講緊個 status 啦，講緊佢嘅誒，講緊佢係邊個 app 啦，邊個分類啦，至少咧係咪有冇 comment 啦，有冇 attachment 啦，啊，所有嗰、那個嗰件事嘅 life cycle 咧就可以喺度 take care 㗎。但係同我頭先咁講一樣啦，最好個 description 咧就得個 title 少少，加丁堆就得㗎啦，唔好寫太多，詳細嘅咧唔該喺 document 嗰邊。因為如果唔係咧，依張 ticket 生老病死完咗之後咧，拜拜㗎啦，你炒都有翻有柴炒 ，OK， 咁所以唔好喺嗰度做 ，OK，next、okay, 有個 ticket， 咁做翻 agile project management 啦，咁點啊？咁其實咧，依邊咧我哋就會先就可能舉咗啲 appen， 即係啲大嘅 topic， 大嘅分類，例如 front end design、back end architecture 啊 ，back end 嗰個 server framework，OK，、okay, 諸如此類啦嚇，中意啦，咁分曬類。咁然後頭先嗰啲變咗 point 嘅嗰啲咧，其實叫做 story 嚟嘅。嗱，記住一樣嘢喎，用 Xform 咧個客其實唔係好鬼有興趣睇你嗰啲 task 嘅 ，task 係你 developer 做嘅嘢嚟嘅咋。唔好話我聽啦，我淨係有興趣，我講咗要有光，你俾到個光管我未嗰種 story。OK， 所以你中間我試過鑽木取火啦，我試過人力發電啦，諸如此類啦，但係都係出咗個光，嗰啲 task 你唔使話我聽㗎，我只要最後我有光。task 係你唔需要 report 俾客聽嘅嘢，但係 story 係你要 commit 個客嘅嘢嚟嘅。OK， 咁所以咧，當個 project manager 同你拆曬啲嘢啦，擺曬落去 Kanban 或者 Scrum 啦，然後咁 developer 咪俾人派單咯，做嘢咯咁。咁佢哋做嘢嘅時候，要睇 requirement 就走翻去個 document 嗰邊睇啦，要寫曲就一陣間去嗰邊 GIT 就叭叭叭叭叭咁係咁寫曲啦。OK， 咁啊，然後有冇玩過 pull request 啊？你哋 GitHub pull request 嗰類有冇玩過？哎呀呀呀呀！吊高嚟打啦，真係。OK， 不過玩得堅，你遲早總會玩 pull request 啦。OK。
叫人。
啊？梗係要叫人 pull 啦，梗係叫人 pull 啦。OK。好，咁其實個做法就係做嗰個奴隸獸就係咁做，做完之後就 send 翻個 pull request 俾阿老大。咁跟住老大就係同你睇，睇完之後如果佢收貨，收貨咪跟住翻嚟入去張 ticket 嗰度咪話你聽 OK 咯。其實成個 life cycle 係咁簡單嘅啫。好啦，咁。所以好似依度咁啦，當 pull request 嚟嘅時候 ，PM 咪睇咯，睇完個 pull request 覺得 OK， accept 咗佢 ，accept 完跟住就 merge 咗落去個 master branch， 然後跟住咪收咗你張 ticket， 咪收你工咯，咁咪做其他 duty 咯咁。 OK， 佢 Agile， 佢 Edilson 嗰度會點做咧？咁佢有個 software 叫 Jira， 咁就點咧？我哋頭先去 conference 嗰邊整咗個設計過嚟啦，咁整完之後，咁佢就去咗個 backlog 排單個單表，咁跟住就拆咗，例如頭十個、頭一百個 task 出嚟，個 story 出嚟就變咗一個 sprint， 例如依兩個禮拜要做，跟住就掟俾人做，就係咁多啦。咁 Jira 嘅嘢啦，咁所以咧頭先要嗰邊 create 咗嘅 ticket 咧，其實頭先我哋睇咗個好 detail 嘅 ticket view 噶嘛，依、這個就係 overall 嗰個 project planning view 嚟嘅，咁依個就叫 backlog 啦。其實本來啲嘢喺曬下邊嘅，咁佢會有，當你話要 start 一個 sprint 咧，上面有個掣，其實 start sprint 咁嘅，跟住撳咗咧，就會嗰班水平尺彈咗出嚟，又將班水平尺咧拉落去，咁你界到十個 task， 佢數翻個時間俾你 total 係廿個鐘，你覺得一個禮拜內要做依廿個鐘係 OK， 咁你咪跟住撳掣咪 start sprint 咯。嗱，咁所以咧喺排緊依個表嘅時候咧，我頭先嗰個技巧就係咩咧 ？High priority 嘅咧就擺上。同 priority 嘅時候咧，嘅時間大嘅咧又擺上 ，OK， 甚至咧，因為有啲係 story， 有啲可以係 bug 噶嘛，有啲甚至個客嘅 improvement request 嚟噶嘛 ，bug 就唔使講噶啦 ，bug 就永遠高高在上 ，bug 就在上，依期要做嘅 story 就在中間 ，improvement 啊或者啲 task 就在下 ，OK， 然後同一類型之後咧就睇 priority 啦 ，blocker 即係佢唔做就其他人喐唔到手嘅咧就在上。transfer 嗰啲感受貼翻挑下，例如寫 comment 咧，唔好睇住個 comment 其實好緊要㗎，而且 comment 會俾人打㗎，吊高嚟打㗎 ，OK，OK， 同埋唔好啲verbal 亂咁寫 A A O O B B B 嗰啲啊，打死你啊 ，OK，Oh my God，OK， 唔好寫啲咁嘅嘢俾人啦 ，OK， 所以 clean up 啲嘢都係一啲 task 嚟嘅，其實嗰啲 OK 唔好理㗎啦 ，OK， 你分咗個 priority 之後。blocker 嗰啲有啲可能係 block 得嚟咧，但係一個鐘或者 block 得嚟可能係廿個鐘嘅，廿個鐘嗰啲在上 ，OK 明唔明？信我啦，信我啦，越痛苦嘅嘢你就先攞咗佢先啦，咁你後邊就有安樂插飯食噶啦。OK 排好咗之後就 start sprint，start sprint 其實就同頭先嗰啲 sprint 差唔多噶啦，咁就只不過左中右咁你就拉跟住就做啦咁。咁但係做嘅當中咧，嗱如果你對咗某個 task 啊 ，OK 做就之後跟住梗係睇 burn down 啦。依、這個係呃鬼嘅，因為我係 demo 嗰個嚟嘅。頭先我嚟之前嘅兩個鐘都喺度做咗依個 powerpoint 時候，即刻 screencast 嘅，即係 screenshot 嘅嘢嚟嘅啫。OK， 假嘢嚟㗎，所以依個係冇咁靚嘅，依個係呃人嘅。OK， 好。OK， 咁頭先講完就係有 document 啦，要知道有啲咩 requirement 啦，跟住真係分工去開工啦，開完工派單開工啊，咁跟住寫曲咯。咁寫曲點啊？冇 SVN 啊，冇 CVS 嗰啲啊，我真係打爆你啊！OK， 有冇人聽過 HG 啊？有冇用過啊？有 HG 啦，有 BSR 啦，有其他嗰啲嘅。BSR 好似係 Ubuntu 用噶嘛
？BSR
係 Ubuntu 用噶嚇，係啊。其實 Ubuntu 得意啊 ，Ubuntu 嗰邊話所有 commit 上去佢 resource 就叫 BSR。轉咗。臨尾梗係轉啦，冇人用啊嘛。OK， 嗱，依個係一個好好嘅驗證俾大家聽咧，就是、technology 唔使用最新嘅，最多人用嗰個就啱噶啦。HG 其實理論上係好用過 GIT 嘅。不過因為 GIT 太多人用啦，咁而且佢一路 improve 得好，所以用 GIT 啊，所以唔使你噶啦。今時今日我諗你啊，有冇車用 VIM 啊？之後你即刻睇翻個 fail message 跟住你咪再 fix 咯。OK， 所以唔緊要噶。我有陣時例如而家我新寫啲 source 上抌上 GitHub， 掟上 CSCI 咧，可能我頭廿個 commit 咧。係試緊點樣 set up Tsz-Yeung CI 同埋結合咧，同埋我啲 Drupal 搜索點樣可以令到佢 run 到第一個 test 個 Hello World 咯。可能㗎，唔緊要㗎，你投廿個 commit 都係為咗要令到個 test environment work 都唔緊要㗎，你即管做咗依件事先，唔好走去寫你啲 key logic 啊，你搞掂你個 testing environment 先啦。講真㗎，你啲金貨嗰啲咧，你我肯定你可以少三分一以上嘅時間去再 re-invent 一啲已經係做咗又試咗又再衰過嗰啲筆咧，你會寫少好多㗎。嚇、啊，你投資多可能五分一嘅時間係寫咗少少嗰啲 test case 嗰數，但係 finally 你可能少咗三分一時間，你可以翻屋企打機㗎。OK， 總之記得寫 test 啦。OK， 咁 CI 就幫你直接 run 埋個 test case 啦，咁跟住睇埋佢得唔得啦。咁所以最後。當你寫咗條新 branch， 你就掟個 pull request 去俾你老大，老大就睇睇個 peer review 下啦，大家 review 下睇下啲嘢啱唔啱啦。OK 嘅話，咁最後有人覺得你 OK 咯，咁咪 commit 咯，咁咪 merge 咯。 OK， 所以曲嗰邊就係咁㗎啦。咁當佢 merge 咗，咁你 duty get done 咁，梗係翻返 PM 嗰邊就將個 ticket set 咗做 done 啦。OK， 依度多少少 screen 啊，因為我如可能我會試腳啊嘛。OK， 好啦 ，Edilson speed bucket， 咁其實佢 Edilson 裏邊其中一個攞嚟做 GIT hosting 嘅，其實佢個道理完全同 GitHub 係一樣嘅嚇。咁、總之你有 ticket 就 create 個 branch 俾佢 ，create 完之後 prompt source 寫曲改，改完 commit push。跟住就 run test case 之如此類，好啦，直接睇卡睇 screen 好噶啦。好，頭先嗰個 ticket view 真係運作嘅時候嗰個 working screen 嗰個樣啦。咁你篤一張 ticket 咧，篤住一張，咁佢就會開咗個側邊俾你睇嘅。佢有好多嘢嘅上邊，我碌到落最底，你會見到咧有個 create branch 呢個掣嘅。OK， 個意思係點啊 ？create branch link。OK， 咁當你一撳咧，佢其實就會飛咗我係 bit bucket。就會話而家咧，我嗰張 ticket 個名，你想 create 做一個乜嘢嘅 branch 啊？究竟係一個 buffet branch 啊，一個 feature new feature branch 啊，定係release branch 啊，諸如此類好多嘢啦。咁嗰啲講緊 branching strategy 嗰啲，我今日唔講啦嚇，應該冇時間講。OK， 咁總之你 create 條 branch， 然後我寫曲啦。OK， 咁我喺 PHP Union 嗰度，我抄咗個新 test case 落嚟。你望唔望到最尾嗰行啊？好似唔係，我望唔到喎。有冇人睇到最尾個行講咩啊？最尾，係啊，有冇可能一加一等於三嘅？一加一梗係唔係三啦？咁所以依一個 test case 寫咗抌上去咧，會 fail 噶。咁會點咧 ？OK，commit 咗，唔理啦，係咪都好。總之我頭先寫咗衰都好啦 ，commit 咗先。commit 咗之後咧，翻返去 original 我張 ticket 睇咧。就而家如果唔係 create branch 啦，而係話有一條 branch 喺度啦，咁一篤開咧就見到依個樣嘅，然後我就可以 create pull request 啦，見唔見到？咁我就可以為咗依張 ticket 所做嘅嗰條 branch create 個 pull request 俾我老大啦。咁老大，咁我 create 個 pull request 嘅時候就話，哦，我有咧堆新嘅 commit 喺度。然後咧，我而家個 commit message default 係咩嚟㗎啦？咁不過咧，我講你聽，其實我知道其實佢會死嘅，我玩你嘅啫，我玩下啫咁。我試下嗰啲 test engine 得唔得嘅啫。咁你寫翻個 message 俾佢咁，啊 create 個 pull request。嗱，你留意一下喎，佢 GitHub 都係嘅喎，佢 GitHub 都好緊要留意一件事，就係頭頂呢兩個，頭頂呢兩個位，你究竟嗰條 branch 想 pull request 去對加邊條 branch？例如一啲 open source 嘅 project 咧，可能會有條叫 master branch， 就係 for release 嘅；有條 branch 係 for development branch， 寫住 develop 嘅。咁你理論上其實應該 pull request 層係去人哋嘅 develop 嘅，跟住就等人哋儲起咗一堆嘅 changes 之後咧，就跟住就變咗 master， 然後就去 release 嘅。OK， 咁所以你要睇清楚頭頂嘅喎，你唔好指錯 branch 喎。指錯 branch 其實係第一個大事，我 SPM 冇一腳伸腳翻去大西洋嗰件事嚟嘅。呢個隊錯咗隔離，你隊錯咗我條 private branch 乜鬼啫？黐線。OK， 好，咁呢度就 create 完個 branch 個 pull request， 其實 GitHub 都係差唔多樣嘅。咁就開始你可以 comment 啦，可以傾偈啦，去成啦。咁當然亦都會可以睇翻個 div 啦，甚至睇其他嗰啲嘢啦，究竟有幾多個 commit 啦。留意一下喎，依度見唔見到呢個紅色啊？因為咧，我依度博咗 CI 㗎啦。咁頭先我寫一加一等於三喎，黐筋，梗係 fail 啦。咁佢就彈咗個紅色俾我啦 ，OK？ 咁所以 PM 如果收到個 pull request 嚟，佢乜嘢都唔使睇嘅 ，discussion 都唔使睇嘅，睇依個先啦。依個如果紅咗又唔知係拜拜噶啦 ，OK？ 明唔明白？好啦，咁死啦！我俾阿 PM 打咗翻屋企啦，咁點啊？咁咪再寫過咯。好啦，一加一今次等於二啦。我 local 行完個 test case， 啊，終於 run 曬都嗰啲 test case 都冇事啦，全部綠燈啦，全部行曬咁多個 test 啦，冇事。好啦。好，再 commit， 再 push 一次，見唔見到呢度多咗句啊？啱啱 recently update， 見唔見到 ？OK， 咁而且見唔見到頭先呢度啊？噔噔噔噔，咁佢就變咗綠色啦，因為我依家係一加一等於二啦嘛，啱啦嘛。好，咁如果我睇翻個標，即係我篤翻頭先嗰個綠色嗰個 tick tick 咧，其實哦，佢啱啱有個標係得咗啦。呢度我未同你去睇標嗰邊先，我未睇 CI， 因為一陣間嗰個 session 講。咁呢度總之你見到有啲嘢係標到得咗啦，好， 睇翻個 commit， 係喎，你頭先有個玩我嘅 commit， 同埋有一個得咗嘅 commit， 玩我嗰個你 fail 咗，得咗嗰個你綠燈啦。咁其實即係而家我收得啦，係咪？咁我睇埋你啲 source code 嘅話，其實我就可以 merge。咁我撳掣做 PM 啦 ，merge， 咁就將佢你見到啦，由翻而家做緊一個 branch merge 翻落去 master 啦。OK， 因為我 bug fix 啊嘛，咪 fix 啲 master 嘅嘢 ，release 嘅嘢咯。OK， 咁然後就會見到。OK， 有你 update 咗，我 merge 咗，然後所以 master branch push 前咗去咗做一個新嘅 commit 啦，有冇問題？其實嗱唔緊要㗎，你講我講我聽有冇嘢唔明，我可以講多次好快嘅，因為 GIT 個 logic 其實係你如果一出到去做 open source community 嘅 contribution 係一個好有用㗎，有冇人係唔明嘅先？我當你明白了，你睇出嚟你我啦，算啦。OK， CI 其實 CI 就好簡單嘅 ，CI 就係奴隸收咯，奴隸收咯，佢就奴隸機械收咯。總之你有 developer 就寫 test 咗寫咗，你 push 咗去 code repository， 我見到你有 push， 我就攞你個 code 去 run 一次 test。test 咗得唔得我就話翻俾你聽，咁多嘅啫。當然你要 define 個 test 啦，你都要 define 個 test 點 run 俾我聽啦。OK， 所以最尾嗰句係佢負責 run 嘅咋，佢負責包嗰份工嘅咋，佢唔包你個 test， 你 define 得啱㗎。如果你寫咗樣嘢係 false 嘅話，而你又即係你真係寫咗個 test 係一加係應該等於三嘅話，你真係入一加一等於三俾佢，佢應該係答你 OK 㗎，你唔好怪佢喎。OK， 明唔明我意思啊？寫 test case 都係 developer 嘅責任嚟㗎，你寫錯咗 test case， 怪得人㗎。不要怪 CI 啊 ，OK？ 好，咁如果擺落去 Alexis 嘅嗰堆嘢咁點做咧？其實佢會再有一個 product 叫 Bamboo 嘅。其實如果你哋可能係 Jenki 啦，如果係出去 GitHub 嘅話，就會 transfer CI 啦，嗰堆咁嘅嘢啦。總之簡單講嚟講，個動作都係一樣嘅啫。你 commit 咗嘢去 GIT， 我就俾人嘎嘎踢著，一踢著我就去翻個 source 嗰度，就邊個打咗我一巴？好，我攞翻佢出嚟睇下你咩回事。Run run， 即係。流嘢嚟嘅，聽翻轉頭，哦得咗喎 ，OK 喎 ，OK， 咁我話翻俾你聽咯，咁咪話翻俾你聽佢得同唔得咯，咁你咪跟住 take care 其他嘢咯。好，咁佢實際運作咧就會好似呢度咁啦，頭先嗰個有 fail 有 OK 嘅嗰個啦。嗱，第一個標係點解咧？因為我啱啱一撳掣佢呢個新 branch 啊嘛，咁佢即刻就同我補底一次，先 run 一 run 啲 source 睇下 branch 個瞬間係咪得先啦。哦，得喎，以呢種 branch 嚟得嘅喎 ，OK， 好，我有第一個 commit。炒咗 ，OK， 再 fix 咗一個 commit， 哦得咗，咁所以 overall 嚟講咧，呢條 branch 個 status 係點啦 ？Overall run 係點樣啦 ？OK， 然後去到依邊 fail 嗰、那個，其實佢都會俾你睇到佢 fail 啲乜嘢㗎。例如好似呢度咁，其實佢講緊乜嘢咧？佢話 fail to ascertain that true matching expected three， 你 expect 一加一等於三。我明明一加一等於二噶嘛，你俾個三我，咁你咪 fail 咗咯。OK， 咁所以依度咧就有個係 F 咗啦，明唔明？咁即係你寫咗幾多個 test case， 佢就同你 run 到有個 unexpected result， 佢就答你 fail。只要一個佢都答你 fail。啊，記得喎，呢啲 test 嘅 system 咧，例如 PHP Unit 呢啲咁咧，有陣時有啲 case 你可以 set 某一啲 test case 係 skip 嘅喎，尤其是可能係當你大改緊某一啲 source code 嘅時候。你可能要焗住將某一部分嘅 test case set 做 skip 先嘅，然後之後打翻著佢，明我意思嘛？所以有陣時 skip 當你 develop 緊咧係冇錯嘅，咁不過當你完曬之後咧，你應該全部都要運行良好，然後跟住 run 到 test case 嘅。OK， 好，咁要得嘅嗰個標咧，得嘅嗰個標其實 run 曬，咁咪綠燈咯，咁跟住呢度咪全部啲點點點都 OK， 咁咪話 OK 咯，就係咁多啦。好啦，去到呢度有冇問題先？因為今天其實好像我已經過了，
我們可以強行佔多十分鐘的，
那不如 Q&A 好過了，那 Q&A 吧。 OK， 後面那些給你一點知識， Branching Strategy 其實剛才有講過一點的，究竟 Release Branch、Bug Fix Branch 或者什麼東西，那些你們有興趣呢，我舉個 Keyword 來 Git Flow， Git Flow FLOW 你學一下吧，Git 配 Git Flow 是非常好用的，我留低啲功課，咁你哋自己去玩下學下啦。OK， code review 就頭先講緊，好似GitHub 嗰種pull request 嘅 review 啦 ，continuous integration 就頭先基本講咗噶啦。 OK， 好啦，依啲嗱依啲例如係佢結合上邊嘅 code review 嘅嗰種樣，所以其實可以 download 到某一行你嘅 commit 嚟對俾 comment 你嘅。我有陣時都會俾人抽清出話嗰行點解啲 code 寫得咁唔 standard 嘅嘢，跟住叫你改翻啱再上我都有嘅。OK， 好誒，頭先 bucket 嘅嗰種樣啦。OK，CI、okay, 嘅嘢啦，咁啊其實冇乜特別嘢嘅。依個係我其中一個 open source 嘅 project。是做啲 all of authentication in PHP 嘅，咁其實我依度 define 咗大堆 test case， 所以我每次有 commit 有 change， 佢就會 tag 咗 TrustCI， 跟住即係我掟咗 GitHub， 掟咗 TrustCI， 跟住佢就會 run 完咧，我嗰個 project 個 README 嗰度咧有張貼紙仔嘅，寫住究竟佢係 build fail build successful， 咁就係睇依個啦。OK， 好啦，依啲其他都冇乜特別嘢啦，其實頭先都有經歷過曬嘅。好，有冇特別問題想問？